Got a little bit of Michael Jackson's Dangerous playing in the background. We're going to have a little conversation today. I am still processing some information and coming up with a strategy for a particular situation. And while I do that, I'm going to take the time to diverse over to explaining a couple of things. So this video with the caption, "What should I say to the court, to the Treasury, to the USDA, and to the bank, if I should be speaking to them?" So let's first talk about the court. You have a situation in the court. Doesn't matter which situation, whether it be criminal or civil, and you're standing before the court. If I'm going to court for the first time and I don't know what's going on and I've never been to court, say, "Excuse me, I have something I need to say." Don't insist, just say, "Excuse me, I have something I need to say." And the judge will say, "What is it?" "Well, the only thing I really know about courts is what I've seen on TV. And however, on TV we know that that's make-believe, that's not real. I don't understand these proceedings. I don't understand what's going on here. And so I'm going to need it explained to me." And then the judge is going to sit up there and, "Really? I get to sit up here and be the teacher? So I'm going to do some explaining. I got to make myself look good. Okay, see what's going on here today." And then they're going to explain all of the gobbledygook. That's right. They're just going to give you a bunch of words. They're going to make it seem like what you saw on TV was legitimate. Well, see, that's where I'm having a problem. You see, I'm having a problem understanding, are these proceedings, let me see, administrative or are they judicial? Now, let me see if I can explain what I mean by judicial. Is it being done under the judicial branch of government, under the Constitution for the state, or is it being done under administrative policy and administrative procedure? You see, that makes a difference. See, if it's administrative, then that means it's not a lawful proceeding. It means that it needs my consent. At least that's what I've been told. So, is my consent, has that been documented on a record? Because I don't have any remembrance of or recollection of giving my consent to such a proceeding. No, I have to say this because my consent, if this is not a judicial branch of government facility, my consent is necessary to be under any type of other jurisdiction. That means that there's no obligation for me to be here, is there, if I don't consent? Man, that person on that bench is going to start talking. No, I just need to know whether or not my consent is necessary for these proceedings to go forth. You see, because if you don't have my consent, and I'm not saying that you have my consent, I'm saying I don't recall consenting, because I would never consent to something that is not a constitutional venue, that's not under the judicial branch of government. Because I would have to challenge the jurisdiction of such an operation. Oh, somebody's going to tell you to go. No, wait, excuse me. No, I'm not going to go sit down. This is my hearing. I don't have to go sit down and wait for you to take care of somebody else. This is the matter at hand. Are you telling me that you can sit up here and waste the court's time by having me go and sit and take a recess when I don't have to do that? Now, the person will get really mad. So when you come back up, because you're going to go sit down, don't argue with them. Go sit down. Okay, now, you still didn't answer my question. So look, I wrote them down. My question was, is this a judicial branch of government proceeding? Wait, you're interrupting me. Why are you being so angry? I'm just asking a question. I have the right to ask questions, don't I? Why, if this was a legitimate proceeding, then you would answer my question, and you haven't answered my question. Is this a judicial branch of government proceeding or not? So you're refusing to answer the question. That's okay. That's okay. I'll put it in writing and I'll send it to the appeals court, and I will put a complaint against you saying that you are refusing to acknowledge the jurisdiction of the court. No, it's okay. It's okay. Okay, my next question was, do you have documentation of my willful consent to these proceedings? Because I don't believe that they are judicial branch of government proceedings. I believe they're administrative proceedings. And if they're administrative proceedings, I'm sorry, I don't have a contract with you. No, no, no. See, driver's license, I don't have one of them things. And no, I withdrew my registration as registered agent for that state-created entity. See, I've resigned as registered agent, and I sent it to the Secretary of State. Both the United States and this state. Here's a copy. Okay, so now, you don't have a license on file with me being an agent for the agency. So I'm not an agent for the agency. I have withdrawn. I did my resignation of registered agent. Oh, by the way, that thing they call a driver's license, no, that's not me signing. See, I sent a notice of change in terms of agreement to the Department of Motor Vehicles. Here's a copy of that. Okay, so no, I'm not a registered agent for that agency. I'm not even an employee for that. I'm not here to represent that agency. That's not mine. That belongs to the state. So you're going to have to go talk to the district attorney for the state, because that's who represents that agency. No, I was resigned as registered agent. I never asked to be registered agent for that agency. That belongs to the state. Yeah, that's the state's agency. That's right. All agencies are registered with the state, so technically the state is the owner of all agencies in the state. Yeah. Mm-hmm. What? I'm talking above your head. No, I can't be talking above your head, because see, the law states that I have to be the registered agent or have to have a license in order for this administrative agency to have jurisdiction over me. You know the law. I don't have to quote the law to you. You already know the law. I don't have to give you statutes and codes. No, because the statutes and codes only apply to those who are registered. What? You want to argue? No, I don't want to argue, because see, you can't even listen to arguments or rationale or any of that stuff, because it's against the law for you to hear any arguments against your administrative policies. No, you can only go by what the agency's policies are. And the agency policy is, I don't have a contract with you. I'm not a registered agent of the agency. Ladies and gentlemen, those who've been around for a while and who understand the courts know exactly what I've just said to the court. I just took all of that jurisdictional stuff and I just condensed it into a conversation. Yeah, the person behind the bench will get upset. They will get angry. That's okay. By the way, all you gotta do is put a motion in the court withdrawing your consent, that resigning of resignation of registered agent, you put that on the record. Remember, you resigned, you sent your notice of change in terms and conditions to the Department of Motor Vehicles regarding your automobile. You sent the notice of change in terms and conditions to the state recorder's office, county recorder's office, letting them know that you are changing the terms and conditions of your filing your property on the record, that it is not the ownership of the state anymore. No, you're retaining ownership of your property. That's right. You're retaining it under your right to property. I need you guys to hold on for just a second. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as you saw, I was installing a program called BlueStacks. Now, if you don't know what BlueStacks is, let me explain. Go and research it, okay? Because we ain't talking about BlueStacks today. We're gonna get back into, that's how we would explain things if we were standing before any court. Because all of the courts are administrative, ladies and gentlemen. They need your consent. Now, they'll say that you signed consent when you registered to vote. So all of those contracts, you have to send in what's called a notice of change in terms and conditions. Okay, it's real simple. You just change the terms and conditions. You don't get stupid. Just say I withdraw any and all consent. I withdraw myself as being any type of registered agent. I withdraw myself for accepting any type of liability for the state-created agency. You do that with all of the agencies associated with yourself. That includes the court case you're in. I know. They'll say, well, that doesn't do this and that. We're not concerned about what they say. Not concerned about what they say. We're concerned about what the actual record will demonstrate. Are you paying attention? We don't care about what they say. They say a lot of stuff. It tells me to program. It was a problem. I've been having a problem with it. That's why I was installing it. So what I have to do is I have to update it, and I'll be doing that very shortly. Now, anyway, that's why we're not caring about what they say. We're caring about how the record is documented. Okay? And you can put in a statement about how you just became aware of this. That you just became aware that somehow you had given consent without trying to give consent. I have to walk over to the other side of the room for a second, so y'all have to excuse me while we segue into the next aspect of our conversation. What's the next aspect of our conversation? Well, let's say we got a mortgage and we gotta call the bank or the servicer, which is commonly a call that each of you are gonna have to make at one point in time anyway. So if I'm calling the bank or if I'm calling the servicer, what's the conversation I'm gonna have with them? Well, let's say I'm calling the bank and I'm calling them about my mortgage. And I'm just gonna ask simple questions. Say, I'm sorry, but I'm told that you are the servicer of my loan. Well, yes, we serviced the loan, blah, 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 blah. It's okay. I'm sorry. Where did you get permission to service my loan? Well, we got permission to service your loan under the deed of trust. Really? Under the deed of trust? Well, hold on 1 second. Okay. No, give me 1 second. Hold on. Deed of trust. Deed of trust. Okay, I have my deed of trust right here. I'm sorry. Where did you say you... I'm looking at it right now. Where'd you say you received permission to service my loan in my deed of trust? Well, we didn't actually receive the right to service your loan in the deed of trust per se. We received it from the beneficiary. You received it from the beneficiary? I don't remember giving the beneficiary permission to service my note. Well, actually, you don't really... Okay, I'll tell you what. I'm going to send them a notice of change in terms of conditions. Yeah, I don't like the way you guys have been servicing my note. You see, I've already sent payment of the note to the beneficiary. Yeah, I sent them the endorsed note, and the law says that they were supposed to do something with the treasury with that note. But that's neither here nor there. What I'm trying to say is I don't like what's going on. It seems that somebody's doing something wrong. I have my records which says the note has been paid, and you guys are still collecting on something that has been completely paid by the treasury and credited to the beneficiary's account. And so we're having a problem. Do I have a copy of that? Oh, no. The beneficiary has that. The treasury sent it to them. So they have the copy. They should have told you guys. You guys, you're supposed to be communicating with each other. Excuse me? Oh, no. I'm not here to... you guys have to talk about that. I'm not here to argue. Oh, no. You're making a statement to me. I'm sorry. I can't handle statements. Tell you what, since you want to argue, and I didn't call to argue, as you can see, my tone, I'm not raising my voice, I'm not yelling, I'm not screaming. No, I understand. Could you put me on hold and get me a supervisor? What, you don't have a supervisor available? Wait, you are an agency, aren't you? You're a company, corporation? Yeah, and you don't have a supervisor. Well, then you just violated several different laws. Yeah, so you can't be a corporation in America without having individuals in superior positions. So yes, of course you have a supervisor. Yeah, I need to speak to a supervisor. Now, this is a recorded call, right? Okay, I just want it to be documented that you're denying me my right to speak to your immediate superior, because you're saying that immediate superior doesn't exist. And yeah, that's it, it's
a violation of my rights, because this is, you're claiming we have a contract, and my contract gives me the right to have access to your superior. So if you don't mind, I'd like for you to correct that mistake you just made by just transferring my call or putting me on hold and sending me to their voicemail. I'll leave a message. Oh, you're going to send me to their voicemail? No problem. Okay. Hello, my name is blah, 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 and I am leaving a message. I just talked to one of your representatives. My note has been endorsed properly as the law requires and has been credited to the actual beneficiary's account as required by statute, and you guys are still attempting to collect. I am having a problem with that. The beneficiary's records do show that they have been credited for the full par value of the note, and yet you're still demanding payment. I will need for you all to send me a copy of your financial records. Now, this is comprehensive, not just a statement. I don't want a statement. Statements are not admissible in court. No, I need the actual certified accounting record. So an audit of the account will do, of my specific account, because see, my account will show, because the law requires you to document the account appropriately as far as every expenditure. So I need to see every expenditure from the exception of the loan. I need to see a chain of custody of the title and of assignments. I have the right to do this, and I have the right to ask for this. So I'm leaving it on this recorded call with this recorded voicemail saying that I made this request. And I'm also going to put this request in writing. Now, you'll have less than 30 days to provide it once you receive it in writing, because I've already done it verbally. So please understand, when you receive it in writing, that's not a continuing of the statute of limitation. The statute of limitation will be ongoing upon the fact that you received this notice verbally and you received it recorded on your voicemail. Well, thank you very much. And oh, my number? No, you don't get to call me back. You must only communicate with me through the United States Postal Service at the address that's located on the note. Okay, thank you very much, and you have a good day. Bye-bye. Now, that's if I'm calling the bank or the servicer or the so-called securitization trustee. I want to see their financial records. This is a financial account. See, that's what you guys have not been understanding. You have the right to require them to show you the ledger, the accounting ledger, which is their comprehensive financial record. It shows all of the debitors and the remittances. It shows every transaction in the account, down to the penny. You have a right to see that. That's what the servicer's job is to do. Now, of course, they're going to do everything in their power not to provide that to you. So you're going to let them know that my records show that this account is paid. And so until you can prove that there is an outstanding debt, I will be making no further payments to your account on your behalf or on anybody else's behalf. I'll be filing a complaint in court to have this matter finally resolved, as we'll pull your financial records in court to prove that this matter has been resolved, that this government obligation has been properly tendered as required by statute. Thank you. Have a good day. Just that simple. I know I make it sound simple, but in reality, it doesn't work that way. Yes, it does. It's just you guys going to court. You just bring up too much junk. Okay? And I want you to pay attention to what I just said. You bring up too much junk. You bring in the kitchen sink, the water heater, the wrenches, the ratchets, the screws, the screwdriver, the nails. You bring in the mortar, the brick. You bring in the drywall. You bring in the fixtures. Ladies and gentlemen, this matter is all about a government obligation. This matter is not about anything else. It's about a government obligation. By the way, that's Jennifer Hudson in the background. I'll be right back.
It would be foolish for me to keep talking while I say I'll be right back, but I'm going to keep talking while I say I'll be right back. Now,
let's go. If I'm calling the United States Department of the Treasury, because the United States Department of the Treasury and I have a conversation we need to have. So I call the Treasury. They say, who may I direct you to? Oh, I need to speak with the department in the Treasury that handles endorsed notes. I'm sorry. I need to speak. Let me say it. I'm going to say it a little slower this time. I need to speak with the department in the United States Treasury that handles endorsed notes. I'm sorry. What do you mean by endorsed notes? It's a note that is endorsed. There is a department in the Treasury that handles, per statute, endorsed notes. What statute are you referring to? I'm referring to all the statutes referring to endorsed notes sent to the Treasury. So, to make this conversation go a little bit smoother, I need to speak to someone in the department that handles endorsed notes. You're going to need to be a little bit more specific. Excuse me? I can't be any more specific than an endorsed note, because that is the exact title of it. It's not an endorsed blah, blah, blah note. It's not an endorsed blah, blah, blah note. It's not a blah, blah, blah endorsed note. It is simply an endorsed note. I'm going to need to speak to a supervisor. Maybe they'll be able to help me, since you are not able to help me. Excuse me. You're trying to argue with me. Okay. Well, you won't give me a code. You won't give me a blah, blah, blah. I've given you the code. The code is in the words. Endorsed notes. It's a government obligation. Oh, government obligations. Well, that's handled through blah, blah, blah. Why didn't you just say government obligation? Because it's an endorsed note. And the code refers to an endorsed note. But if you need to hear somebody say government obligation. Oh, just hold on 1 second. Click.
The Bureau of Public Debt. How may we direct your call?
I need to speak to the department in the Treasury that handles endorsed notes.
Well, that'd be the Bureau of Fiscal Services. Let me transfer.
Nope, sorry. Hold on. They just transferred me to you. They told me you were the proper department.
They did, huh?
Yes, so transferring me back to them is just going to be a waste of my time. I just need to speak to the department that handles endorsed notes. The statute says that the conventional mortgage is a government obligation in the United States, because all property in the United States is owned by the United States. Thus, it's a government obligation. And I need to know which department in the Bureau of Public Debt handles endorsed notes. And where is the form for submitting the endorsed notes? Well, that's going to be the form number 1522. And you're going to send that to blah, 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 blah. Okay, along with a copy of the note. Thank you very much. That's what I need to know. Now, I need to know, what's the process? Once you all receive the endorsed note, what's the process? And how do we do an endorsed note that's credited to the Treasury? Credited to the account of the Treasury. I need to know, what's the procedure for that? What do you mean by credit to the account of the Treasury? Well, I can endorse my note and credit it to the account of the Treasury. How does one go about doing that? If you can put me on hold and let me speak with a supervisor so they can tell me, because it seems like you've never been posed that question before, and you guys haven't had your meetings to figure out how to not respond to the question. So could I speak with a supervisor? Maybe they can help me with understanding how I can endorse my note to the credit of the United States Treasury. Put you on hold. Then you'll hear me saying in the back of your mind, Patriot or the United States Treasury is crediting it to the United States Treasury. and then they'll come back off hold.
Yes, this is Jim. I'm the supervisor. I'm told you had a question.
You kept me on hold for that long, and the person did not explain to you what my question was? Well, he did explain. Well, then why would you ask me to tell you the question all over again? That seems a little bit... Well, that's just in case he didn't understand the question or it was not given to me the correct way. Then that would mean that your employee is incompetent, and I don't think you would hire incompetent people. So can we just move on with answering my question? Okay. Well, it seems to me your question is... How does one... Blah, blah, blah. No, my question was... How does one credit... their endorsed note to the credit of the Treasury? What is the procedure for doing so, since the law permits one to do as much?
Well, there is actually no procedure.
Of course there's a procedure. Everything in your particular department, everything in the Department of the Treasury follows a procedure. There's a written procedure for every single thing that's done in your offices, so please don't tell me there's no... Well, look, I'm not going to argue with you, but you are arguing with me. I'm telling you I need to know the procedure, and you're telling me that you're going to lie to me and tell me that there is no... And I don't want to argue with you. I just want you to tell me what is the procedure. Now, if you have a policy that says that you can't tell me the procedure, then you're violating public policy, because public policy requires you to answer my procedural question as long as it deals with your particular department. So please stop giving me a hard time. That's how you handle a conversation with them. You turn the conversation back on them as they did something wrong. You don't argue with them. You don't loud talk them. You don't treat them with disrespect. You do, however, say to them, please, don't do that.
Don't do what?
Don't sit up here and treat me as if I don't know what I'm talking about. And when I called to ask the question, I didn't know what I was asking in the first place. Please understand that I asked the question because I know why I'm calling. I know why I'm asking the question, because I know the law permits this. So if we can just get past all of the blocking of the access to the answer and just give me the answer, and then this conversation will be over and you can go about helping the next person or discouraging the next person. Well, look, we don't just see you just change the subject again. Nobody was talking about you discouraging anyone. The issue is getting an answer to my question. It's not about you taking parts of my conversation and only figuring out the part that's what you want to hang on. We're going to stick to the topic of conversation. The topic was this. That's what I need an answer to. I don't need an answer to whether or not you discourage people from calling by sitting up here not giving them the answer to their questions. That's not what the conversation is about. And then you go on from there. You'll find that once you start pinning them down as to, no, you're doing this and I don't appreciate that, they will start getting a little bit more to the point with you. Okay, now you're gonna call the USDA. Now your note is insured by the United States government. You have a government guaranteed note. However, pay attention. You're not going to call them and tell them you have a government guaranteed note. You are calling to ask them who handles endorsed notes. Well, what type of endorsed note? One that is guaranteed by the United States government. Well, what's the property address? Excuse me. I'm not asking about my property. I'm asking about the policies and procedures for handling endorsed notes. Well, we need to have a... No, you don't need to have a property address. I'm calling about your policy. I'm not calling about a property. If I was calling about a property, I was saying, be calling and asking you, who handles my property, blah, 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 blah. That wasn't my question. My question was specific regarding your policy. Listen to the word, policy. Not property. I know they both start with a P, okay? But because they both start with a P, doesn't make them part of the same group of words. So let's get back to my question. My question is one that's on policy. I need to know your policy for who handles endorsed notes.
Well, excuse me.
You are deciding that you're not going to help me. You're not going to cooperate by answering my question.
You're going to be difficult. So, what's your supervisor's name?
Well, we can't give out... Excuse me, what you mean you can't give out your supervisor's name? Of course you can. Supervisor's name and extension so I can call them directly. They are not going to like that, ladies and gentlemen. They're going to actually hate that. Okay? They're going to hate it, hate it, hate it. Okay? Now, I am waiting, ladies and gentlemen, for everybody and their grandmother to get that when you're calling and asking questions, you have to get the answers you can on the first call. You know what the responses were on the first call, so then you're going to call back later after you figured out how to ask the question a different way to get a more definitive answer. And then you're going to call back again to find out how to ask the question in a more definitive way. Okay? Now, I wish to do the very best I can to help you in all areas, but as you can see, this will help you for the most part. You're just going to have to listen to it a couple of times, and you're going to have to understand that this anticipates the responses. Why? Because I've done these calls so many times and gotten all of the responses, so my responses is to get around their stupidity and their responses. With that being said, we're going to let this, how would I respond to the Treasury, the court, the USDA, and the bank. You know what I'm saying? Y'all take care. Have a good day. Have a good night. And we will speak in a good while. Goodbye.